when the space shuttle program got underway 30 years ago, a tweet was nothing more than the sound that a bird made. But things have changed.
Oh, that they have. And now tweeting is something that we all do. And for dozens of space enthusiasts, it was the key to getting a very rare look inside the Johnson Space Center today.
KPRC Local 2 reporter Carl Willis is going to show us how the social networking tool Twitter has several dozen civilians on the floor of Mission Control.
Welcome on board as we orbit the Earth 230 miles above in low Earth orbit.
And we want to welcome the tweets to the Johnson Space Center in all of its uniqueness. Please take the time to go visit the stuff that's around there. The three of us as Astro underscore Jeff, Astro underscore Suichi, and Astro underscore TJ.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to JC. I hope you enjoyed the tweet up today. And the tweet has, it's only text-based, but it has a lot of possibilities. And the good thing is all the international partners can join together, English, Japanese, Russian, you name it. So I hope all the conversation will continue in the virtual world.
By the way, we're really enjoying our internet access here, so thank you for your support and participating in that.
And if you guys are tweeting from the tweet itself, please append to your tweets #, NASA tweet up, and we can follow you from up here.
Have a great day. All the best.
Without further ado, I want to introduce, here's Bobby Satcher.
I'm going to show you a video first, which are some highlights from our recent mission.
Good.
These are no ordinary tweeps. They're a select group of NASA's devoted followers on Twitter. And they've come from around the world for a chance to tweet and even meet an astronaut.
I know, 3 days to see you from California.
Atlanta Earth Science teacher Janelle Wilson was one of the 90 randomly chosen followers, and she came with questions from her students.
They really want to know what's it like to be in a weightless environment, what's it like to eat in space. And
astronaut Bobby Satcher had the answers to those questions. He flew on STS-129. And says the tweet-ups, as they're called, bring some extremely knowledgeable supporters.
I asked them to write a couple questions, and overall what they were wondering is, what's it like sleeping and exercising in space, if you get scared, and is it fun?
Well, I'll start with the last question, because that's the easiest one. Yeah, it's fun. Then we can back up and let's see, sleeping and exercising, do you get scared? Getting scared, no. I think, we just spend so much time training for it that by the time you get to the actual day of the launch, you're really just anxious to go.
You know, it kind of keeps you on your toes, but I think it's a lot of fun. It gives a chance to give something back.
Thank you.
the International Space Station and from the station.
Well, it's great to talk to you guys. I wanted to, first of all, just say that we've got a bunch of very excited young people here with us, along with a bunch of somewhat excited teachers. We have one engineer and one member of Congress. So yeah, you've got a whole bunch of press here. So it's a pretty motley crew, and one president.
Two astronauts are from Maryland.
but I just wanted to let you guys know how proud we are of all of you.
Volunteers, so I'm going to turn around. Oh, look, this is a serious bunch here, I can tell. So I'm going to hand the phone over to first one. Hold on. This is Ruth, coming from North Carolina.
What are some of the benefits of exploring space as opposed to exploring other places on Earth?
Better have a good answer than the NASA folks who are sitting there listening.
Ruth, I can tell you your curiosity reaches far, and so does ours, and that's sort of the human spirit to find out what can humans really do. One thing that's always been, I think, amazing to every person who travels in space is that the human body is adaptable to this environment.
We thank you for your courage, and tell your families we appreciate them letting you float up into space like this. All right? Bye-bye, guys.
Oh, my God.